I cannot tell you how important it is for science teachers to come up with high interest projects. The more hands-on, the more creative, the more engaged your students are going to be.
Your mission: use the engineering and design process to create an insulated container that will protect your pumpkin from breaking when dropped from a lift truck at the height of
blank feet,
yeah.
Rules. Number one,
your pumpkin all insulation must fit inside your box. Number two, you may use any insulating materials you bring from home or I have in the classroom. Three, you must work as a team, keeping in mind with the PBIS expectations for working with others. Number four, create a team logo or swag for the outside of your box. Five, have fun.
The big test was not to have the pumpkin break.
You are going to be able to choose your pumpkin. We're going to do a little walk right now. You're going to be able to walk over with your group silently. You may only whisper and take just a couple of seconds to look through the pumpkins. And then I will tell you who has been randomly selected to pick their pumpkin first.
Get the smallest. I think we should get a bigger one because it could take more impact.
But the smaller ones would have a harder time breaking because the impact would be too hard on the bigger ones because the gravity would pull it down.
That's true. But bigger ones, they might have deeper. Because I cut a big pumpkin before and it's like, it's deeper. It's more thicker.
Or you know how when you cut a pumpkin?
Yeah, we need a hollow one because if it's hollow, you know it's pretty deep.
Yeah,
this one is good.
I think this one.
I think we should get that pumpkin.
The one that all of us agreed on because it's hollow.
Well,
it's a good size to help the impact.
Maybe we should get the. I disagree with you because you know how it's hollow? It might be easier. It might break more.
Yeah.
But if it's.
But I disagree with you because if there's a lot of the stuff it will probably break it more. Because if it's hollow, it'll help with the impact less, or like with the gravity.
I can see what you're saying.
I agree with you.
The standards I was addressing in this project are the engineering and design standards, which are part of the next generation science standards for K-12. And they start with planning and investigation. They have to do research, and then they have to create a model, and then they have to test. At the end, ultimately, they're testing their design, and then they're given time to improve upon it. So here are the things I want you to work on today, okay? Number one, I want you to finish working on your research part. This is where we are in our engineering process.
I have the.
I think we should add on to that. The suspension
Add on to it.
It should be connected to like the bottom of the box, and then have it like go up, and then we can kind of clip the pumpkin to make it secure.
So I'm gonna add on with yours.
Yeah. Okay.
Put the bottles on the bottom. I put the freaking
the towel,
and then.
Towel, then kind of wrap it around the pillows.
I think we had such a high level of engagement because this was a high leveled project. It presented a challenge. They were excited. It was fun. Measuring, I don't think that the kids thought measuring or finding circumference or weighing something or having to research could be as much fun. But the more fun it seems to them, the less it seems like learning sometimes, and that produces high engagement.
I would rather be working on the actual design process instead of reading a book because I like reading. It's fine, but like that doesn't interest me, just reading about pumpkins.
One of the reasons why I do these kind of projects with the kids, even though it takes me completely out of my comfort zone, my room is in chaos, it seems to any outsider, it's messy, it's loud, is that our students spend too much time indoors these days and not as much time creating. They're getting to be a real live engineer. They have a purpose, and for a lot of our kids, they need some kind of purpose.
I would like to do more science stuff, like creating stuff, because it's more hands-on and like I'm more active, so yeah.
Remember, engineers, they go test, improve, test, improve until they get the best possible design for whatever innovation or technology they're using. So that's how you're thinking today. Don't think this is the end and we either succeeded or failed. Think of it as this is our test. How can we make it even better?
Our principal, Mr. Arquez, he brought a, I don't know what it was called, a lift.
I got it.
And then he dropped the pumpkin from a 45 feet, I believe.
My favorite part of the whole project was the pumpkin drop. Watching everyone's drop, seeing their reactions, seeing if the pumpkin would break or not.
I'm scared.
It might not open. We put too much
stuff. Do you think moving on field, did it make it?
I think no, it did.
I don't think it did.
I think it did because it didn't even crack the box. Oh, it did.
Yes,
oh, it's right here.
These students are going to leave here so excited for science, and hopefully they'll want to take that on into their lives and just want to discover and inquire and create and test.
But they cracked it.
They cracked just a tiny bit. I was the one that cracked the less out of all of them.
Well, we had a bit more insulation than the other groups because we brought our own materials, and we had these pool noodles on the edges too.
And we made pillows out of.
Yeah, we made some pillows.
Well, it was my idea to bring the pool noodles because, like, we decided that so we could, like, have it on the edges for, like, the, like, it was like a car bumper.
Like, if it, like, yeah, flipped over and hit the side.
Yeah, and then Gloria's idea was to make the pillows so, like, we could have more cushion and
I
not buy
one,
any.
She made this one.